Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello ma'am, hello everyone. We are from group 6. We're gonna present about our material, biological control of and members of group 6. 132, Rizkia Huba. Number 136, YSKL Aldi, number 198, and Rumampuk Yunita, number 199.
First is introduction. Corn or zeamites is one of the commodities that have an important role in agricultural development and improvement in the Indonesian economy. Corn is also a type of food commodities that have the potential as an effort diversification that can support resilient food in Indonesia. There are two types of planthopper, which include into the family the Pasidae, known as pests on corn plants. There are Peregrinus maitis and Stenocranus pacificus, otherwise known as the white-bellied planthopper. Peregrinus maitis not only damage corn plant, but can also transmit viral disease called MMV or maize mosaic rhabdovirus and MSTV or maize tenuivirus. Peregrinus maitis species of corn planthopper attack corn plants in the vegetative phase, which is between 15 until 42 days after planting. The impact of attack this pest is damage to young seedlings, growth plants become stunted, planted to transmission of disease-causing virus and decrease in yields. Stenocranus pacificus attacks begin with a white wax like cotton on the side leaf abaceal. This white wax is produced by female planthoppers. This planthopper can also damage corn plants indirectly by producing secretory substance. This substance can be used as a substrate for the growth of sooty mold. At high attack intensity, planthopper can cause plant die to drop like burning at plain egg for until 5 ms, name hopper burn. Classification between Peregrinus maitis and Stenocranus pacificus are same because they have the same family. The classification is kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera, suborder Auxenorhynchia, family Delphacidae. And then for Peregrinus maitis, they have genus Peregrinus and species Peregrinus maitis. And for Stenocranus pacificus, they have genus Stenocranus and species Stenocranus pacificus.
Okay, the next topic is corn planthopper life cycle. Peregrinus maitis. Female corn planthoppers lay 20 to of their host plant. Under normal condition, development from hatching to adult takes about 20 days. However, the development of corn planthopper nymphs is highly dependent on the temperature. Normal development occurs 7 degrees Celsius and has 5 nymphals. Juvenile state to reproduce throughout the year, but is change in temperature. Another factor that influences development is the availability of nutrients. Stenocranus pacificus. The female planthoppers insert its eggs between the midrib and leaf sheets using an ovipositor. One by one in a zigzag fashion along a path parallel to the leaf bone. After ovipositon, the female imago covers her egg with a white waxy substance on her lower abdomen on the abaxial side of the leaf. Nymphs have 4 instars. Each instar averages 3 to 4 days. The color of the nymphs varies from whitish at emergence to yellow-green in the second instar and turn brown in the next instar. The imago is orange-brown in color and its lifespan is 7 to 10 days. The female imago has lower abdomen, which is used while the lower abdomen of the male imago is orange, like orange.
The next is symptoms. When hopper attack begins with the presence of white wax like cotton on the abaxial side or bottom surface of corn leaves, indicating the location of oviposition. This white wax is produced by female plant hoppers and it's called white wax. Wax is a kind of mass created by female leaf hoppers to protect their eggs in leaf dots or stripes. The mark is a leaf hopper puncture mark. And other symptoms were also indicated by the presence of white spots on the base of the leaves, which indicated the emergence of leafhopper nymphs and imago on the surface of corn leaves. Symptoms of this attack make the leaves appear to have yellow striped spots, short discontinuous to continuous lines, especially on the second and third leaf bones, as on the leaf midrib. So that plant growth will be inhibited, become stunted, plant become white or burn.
The next is integrated pest management of plant hopper. The species of plant hopper that infest corn is the Peregrinus maidis and Stenocranus pacificus. The first is pest monitoring through survey or field scouting, and then cultural practice, set growing distances to keep air circulation, planting selmogenous to minimize attacks and control the weeds. For mechanical and physical measures, one of mechanical control technique is using traps, especially sticky trap. The application of sticky trap involves red, yellow, and green paper traps that are glued to the paper surface. For use natural enemies or parasitoid augmentation and conservation. For example, for natural enemies or parasitoid are Elopidae and Mimo. And then using biological agent, example Metarhizium anisoprie and Bavaria basiana, and then using varieties resistant or tolerant to various for the mechanism of Bavaria have been reported to produce secondary metal Bacillus ridin, bevericin, bacianolid, beverolites, tenelin, and osporin, which can area basiana after successfully entering the insect's body will release bevericin toxin, which causes damage to the insect's body tissue. 2 days later, the fungus will grow to all parts of the insect body. Early symptoms of Bavaria basiana infection in insect are insect not eating, weak movements, moving erratically or losing is Mantarhizium. Mantarhizium attack insect, Hera, Hemiptera, Diptera, and Coleoptera. This fungi can do penetration into the host insect body through two ways that the entomopathogenic fungi were removed. According to Permadi et al. 2019, that Mantarhizium have conidia that have parallel chains. This parallel chain is formed when conidia are formed in large quantities. Fungi attack insect characterized by the insect's body becoming stiff and hard. Insect body of the insect will come out hypae, which depending on the fungus that attacks insect. And the last is chemical control measures. When the population are high and above the economic threshold, it's possible to use an insecticide spraying application of synthetic chemicals active chlorpridium, bearing train and insecticide synthetic chemical ingredient. Thank you. If any question, please put in our Spiders forum.